The Rings of Saturn. In 1610, Galileo became the first person to look at Saturn through a telescope. He described Saturn as having ears, and later hypothesized that two large bodies were in orbit of Saturn. Christian Huygens was the first to identify them as a ring in 1655 when he wrote,
"Saturn is surrounded by a thin, flat ring, nowhere touching, inclined to the ecliptic."
In 1675, Giovanni Cassini determined there were multiple rings with gaps in between them. Debate ensued through the centuries as to what the rings were made of. Were they solid? Were they liquid? James Clerk Maxwell solved this in 1856, determining that Saturn's rings were made up of numerous small independent particles. So how did this wondrous ring formation come to be? The first theory came from Pierre Simon Laplace in 1787. He theorized that Saturn's rings were leftover material from the formation of Saturn that never accreted to form a moon. This has become known as the condensation theory. In 1849, Edward Roche proposed the theory that a moon of Saturn came too close to the planet and was disrupted by tidal forces, leaving behind the rings. Other theories have come and gone over the years, but in the early 21st century, these two theories were still the most plausible explanations. When the Cassini spacecraft entered orbit of Saturn in 2004, we were finally able to get some answers. Data analysis from the Cassini mission led to the discovery that Saturn's rings are quite young, having formed around 100 million years ago. Data also revealed Saturn is losing its rings, and they will be gone in less than 100 million years. This new information rules out the theory that Saturn's rings were leftover material from the formation of Saturn. While trying to solve the reason for Saturn's 26.7 degree tilt, a team of scientists led by MIT Professor of Planetary Sciences, Jack Wisdom, created a new hypothesis. It has long been suspected by astronomers that an orbital resonance between Saturn and Neptune was responsible for Saturn's tilt. However, the team discovered that Saturn was once in orbital resonance with Neptune, but has since escaped its grasp. Through a series of meticulous calculations and computer modeling, the team hypothesizes that Saturn is missing a moon. Their hypothesis, which was published in September of 2022, states that a large moon about the size of Iapetus, which they named Chrysalis, was perturbed by Titan, slowly getting closer to Saturn until it was disrupted, thus forming the rings. The team estimates this disruption happened between 100 to 200 million years ago, which is in line with the 100 million year old estimate of Saturn's rings. This hypothesis also seems to solve a few other mysteries, such as the recent loss of resonance between Saturn and Neptune. It also explains the reason for Saturn's tilt and precession. And it explains the unusual orbit of some of Saturn's other moons, such as the eccentricity of Titan. All of these recent discoveries, made largely in part from the data gathered from the Cassini space probe, seems to be confirming what the Urantia book claims.
Saturn's rings are the fragments of a disrupted satellite.
Thanks for watching. Let us know your thoughts in the comments.